So here we're going to show you how to read a micrometer in four quick steps, which actually are four questions that you're going to ask. Our first question that you're going to begin with is, what is the range of the micrometer? And each of these questions is going to give you a number that you will add up at the end to get your answer. Now, every micrometer measures a span of 1 inch, but they have different ranges. For example, this is a 0 to 1 micrometer. It'll measure anything from 0 up to 1 inches. You can always recognize a 0 to 1 micrometer because it will close completely. By the way, it should never be stored completely closed. We have a 3 to 4, a 2 to 3, but for our example, the micrometer I have in my hands here matches the one on the screen, and that is a 1 to 2 inch micrometer. It's going to measure everything from 1 inches up to 2 inches. So to answer this question, a 1 to 2 micrometer, our first number that we're going to start with is 1 inch. Everything we measure with this will be 1 inch or larger. Moving on to our next question, what is the largest number visible on the sleeve? So we're going to use this example provided by Starrett, and we want to identify the largest number and the line for that largest number that we see visible on the sleeve.
In this example, the 4 is the last number visible, representing 400 thousandths.
As you can see in this example, the largest number is a 4. So we're going to write that as 0.400. Now, I recommend carrying out that out 3 decimal places every time. That'll help keep your columns correct. And remember our different places. The first decimal place is the tenths. Then we have the hundredths, and the third is the thousandths. With this micrometer example, we'll be measuring to the nearest thousandths. Our next question is, how many lines are visible after the number? So we just identified that 4 was the last number visible. We now want to count the lines after that and determine our reading.
3 intermediate lines are visible, representing 3 times 25, or 75 thousandths.
As you can see, with 3 lines visible, each of them are worth 25 thousandths, so the number to add would be 0.075. Don't forget to add the 0 in there. It should be 0.075, or 75 thousandths. That now takes us to our final question, our fourth question, and that is, what number aligns on the thimble? The thimble is the part of the micrometer that spins, so you want to look at what number aligns with this horizontal.
The number on the thimble that aligns with the sleeve center line is 1.
As you can see in this video, the 1 lines up closest with our horizontal, so that would be 1 thousandths. The number you're going to get is going to be anywhere between 1 and 25, or 24. At 25, it would begin to reveal the next number. So your value for this would be anywhere between 1 and 24 thousandths. Make sure you write it in the proper decimal places. So in this case, it's 0.001. Our final step is to add up our numbers that we got. When you add up this column of numbers, you get 1.476 inches for this micrometer reading. I recommend while you're learning to use the micrometer that you write down these values for each step, add them up. That way, if you get a wrong value, it's easy to check your work and see where you went wrong.